After a decade of cumulative disturbances, including 3 mass coral bleachings in 5 years, the fourth wave of crown of thorns starfish outbreaks, and numerous severe tropical cyclones, the reef has had a reprieve and has entered a window of recovery. To put it simply, the reef has had a breather. It's had time to regenerate, and that's a window we haven't seen for a few years. The results from this year's surveys from the long-term monitoring program have shown that coral cover has increased across all regions of the Great Barrier Reef in the last 2 years. This is great news for this iconic system, but as our monitoring has shown into the past, this window of recovery can quickly reverse. One marine heat wave or severe tropical cyclone can undo all the recovery to date. And the prognosis is that these events will become more frequent, reducing the windows for recovery. That's why it's important to set the results from this year into the context of the 35-year data set. This report is based on hard coral cover, which is a robust and well-known measure of coral reef condition. But it doesn't delve deeper into aspects of coral reefs, like the diversity or the makeup of coral species. And this is where our fixed site surveys come in. They provide more detailed information and allow us to delve deeper into the functioning of coral reefs. These detailed surveys have shown that much of this recovery was due to the fast-growing table and branching corals. These corals take a little while to get established, but once they do, they hit a period of really fast exponential growth. And it's been this period of fast growth which has coincided with the recent window of low disturbances. It's important to realise that these corals are fast to grow, but they're also the first to go. Their speed of growth comes at a cost, and their skeletons are fragile. This means they can be easily broken by waves generated by tropical cyclones. They're particularly susceptible to mass coral bleaching and are the preferred prey of crown of thorns starfish. This means that any reef with high numbers of these corals is at greater risk of decline. We know that reefs can recover, we've seen this before, and this year shows that the Great Barrier Reef is still resilient. We will continue our long-term, large-scale monitoring of the reef and research on adaptation to understand how it can best survive into the future.